Hi, I'm Chris Cahoon, one of the QLab developers, and I want to show you a few features that QLab has to help you save time when making revisions on an existing Q list. As you can see, I have a workspace with some existing cues, audio cues to represent the white noise inside an airplane, the kind of chimes that come on when the fasten seatbelt light turns on and off, and some lighting cues that match situations on an airplane. The last person who worked on this added some flags to my cues. You can see the flag icon here on the left, which is also represented in this flagged checkbox in the inspector. To see what all these flags are about, I'm gonna go to the warnings area of QLab by clicking this icon. And I can see that all of them have the same feedback, which is all of them need to have their file replaced. So I'm going to try to change all of these cues all at once to save myself time. First of all, I'm going to use the Find tool, which you can find under the Edit Find menu, to search for all of these cues at once by typing its cue name. All right, airplane alerts louder.mp3. I found all four of the ones I want to change. I'm going to click Select Found. And as you can see, my inspector has all four of the cues selected, so I can edit all of them at once. I'm going to change all of them to have a different file by double-clicking on the target and selecting a new file name. And as you can see, all four of them changed at once. I'm gonna rename them to Cabin Chime while I'm here. Oops, Cabin Chime. And I'm also going to unflag them while I'm here because I solved the problem. I'm gonna click Done in the Find bar to make the highlights go away. And voila, I've solved the direct feedback I received about these chimes. I've also received feedback that the fasten seatbelt sign should take less than 5 seconds to turn off and on. I'm going to repeat this process of batch editing, but this time I'm going to use clicking, command clicking, that is, by hitting the command key and selecting all of my fasten seatbelt lighting cues at once, and I change all of their duration at the same time in the batch editor. And as you can see, all of them now have a duration of 0 so that the fasten seatbelt light turns on and off instantly. Now it turns out that when I replaced the file for all of the cabin chimes, I replaced it with a file that has more than one chime in it. So for all four of these cues, I actually need to trim the start and end time to make sure that the chime is actually correct. So again, I'm going to select a chime cue, but this time I'm only going to change one at a time. The reason for that is I'm going to use paste cue properties to change all of these cues. So I'm going to get the first one correct, and then I'm going to copy that cue and then paste its start and end times on the rest of them. I'm going to demonstrate that now. So I've set the start and end time. While I'm here, I'm going to unflag the cue. And now I'm going to use paste cue properties. So first I go to edit and copy. So I've copied this cabin chime cue that has everything that I want in it. And now I'm gonna select the other cabin chime cues. I'm gonna go to edit, paste cue properties. I'm gonna make sure that I select my start and end time out of this long list of properties. And I'm also gonna select the flagged property. Now you can see that all the rest of my cabin chimes are no longer flagged and have the correct start and end time. Paste cue properties is great for taking just one or a few properties from a cue and propagating them out to many cues. If you have multiple identical copies of the same cue and keep having to make the same changes to all of them, a really good solution is to actually only use one of those cues and then use start cues to make that cue go when you need it to go in the show. To demonstrate this, I'm going to select my first cabin chime cue, go over to the cue bar, and make a new start cue. By default, this cue already targets my cabin chime cue, but if you needed to manually target a cue, you might want to give your cue a number, like chime. And then inside your start cue, you can set the target name to match the cue that you're starting. Now, if I run just start cabin chime, you can see that the cue start cabin chime starts, but it also fires cabin chime. So if I copy start cabin chime and put it next to all of the places where I have cabin chime, then I can also delete all of those duplicate cues and just run cabin chime anywhere I need to. Now I can change my authoritative cabin chime cue as much as I like. For example, setting the main volume, making it so that it comes out of both speakers, and those changes automatically happen when I call start cabin chime elsewhere in the workspace. One final tip is that if you're using a cue many, many times, and you might need to use it at a random time in the performance, it can be helpful to either set a hotkey trigger on that cue. For example, if I wanted to put the hotkey trigger G on my cabin chime, because I know that hotkey is available, now, whenever I want to use a cabin chime, I can press the key. Hopefully these workflow tools save you some time the next time you work on a show. Thanks for watching.